Hey guys, how's it going and welcome back for another Total War video with the Terminator. Today, I want to talk about the new DLC coming to a Total War Saga Troy. RHESUS and Memnon was announced by Creative Assembly yesterday, and it will be adding two new factions, 49 units, lots of new gameplay mechanics and culturally unique gameplay mechanics as well with these factions. But generally, we're going to be getting some new content for Troy, which is a great thing because a title like this to keep getting support is fantastic in and of itself. And also, just, you know, inherently looking at the factions, looking at the units, the new gameplay mechanics, it all sounds really, really good on paper as well. So the reason why I want to make this video is because a lot of you have been asking me, Terminator, what do you think about the new DLC announcement? What are your honest opinions about this DLC? So here I am. I'm going to be telling you my thoughts, honestly. What do I think about it? What do I think about Troy generally? Whether this DLC is really worth it, etc. I mean, I'm not going to say go and buy this or don't, because obviously I haven't played it yet. I don't know if it's any good or not, but on the surface, at least, it looks quite cool. So I want to delve into this a little bit and explore my thoughts and tell you what I think, basically. So let's start from the top, all right? Troy had a bit of an identity crisis. We can all agree, we have to be honest about this, because what Troy was trying to go for, depicting the Trojan War, which already has very little historical account for anyway, in a way that actually artistically is more reminiscent of the Warhammer games, kind of in a more fantasy style, rather than the kind of style that you would see in a kind of historical setting, because this is kind of a historical setting. Let's be honest here. These characters did, you know, these people existed in history. This conflict did happen. You know, you can actually go and see the remnants of the city of Troy in Western Turkey. This all happened. But the way it's all depicted here in a Total War Saga Troy, the art style that they went with is a lot more mythological than it is historical. So that's first. Second, the kind of DLCs that have already come out for Troy with the Amazonians, with the Mythos mode, and now with RHESUS and Memnon as well. It's just kind of overall, it's moved further and further away from any kind of historical take on the Trojan War, and it's become more mythological. You know, let's face it. What CA is trying to cater to here, the audiences that are going after, especially with this DLC as well, is properly mythological. Let's go after the Warhammer player base and try and convince them that this is a good game to pick up. Now, I personally think that Troy is missing a lot. You know, gameplay-wise, the AI essentially, for me, in my personal experience, for some reason, the Trojan factions always somehow ending up invading the Greek side one way or another, which is just kind of ridiculous. There's no real variation from a campaign map perspective, from city to city, faction to faction. You know, you have all these fantastic factions, and they have unique gameplay mechanics, but, you know, on the surface, they look all exactly the same. All these cities look exactly the same. The geographic, the terrain that has been built around Greece and Western Anatolia here, it's all very samey, and the factions on the surface from a unit perspective as well is all very samey as well. I mean, the unit variety doesn't exist because you're going from lower tier units to higher tier units, and you have to replace those lower tier units essentially. You don't have any battlefield use for them. They have no role. And, you know, the fact that you can now hire, rent, take on mythological units in your armies to replace some of this lack of variety is just a bit of a cop-out, in my opinion. And you know what? In my honest opinion, RHESUS and Memnon is the final nail in the coffin, because Troy had an identity crisis, and now we're getting a DLC depicting characters that didn't really have a lot to do with the Trojan War. In fact, if you know your Trojan history, Memnon died within the first day of the conflict. And the fact that This is the worst part for me. The fact that Memnon is created as a faction that essentially depicts that he represents the rest of the Bronze Age world in this game is a bit of a punch in the gut for people who really want Bronze Age Total War, right? And it's happening this way, and I just think it's a bit of a shame. Like, what this game could have been, what it went for from the outset as a saga game, is a flashpoint conflict in history, right? And it took a more mythological take on it, which is fine. But what it should have been, in my opinion, and what many people agree on out there, is that It should have done away with the kind of arcadey Warhammer-esque artistic and gameplay features, and it should have really encapsulated the entire Bronze Age world with two flashpoints, the Trojan War and of course the Sea People's Invasion. All these things could have been done in a much more fleshed out and interesting, culturally interesting and engaging way. That didn't happen. Instead, we got lots and lots of cities that we have to conquer on our way to the AI, which ends up actually sending five stacks of armies across the sea anyway to invade your cities. And it's just like, this isn't really the Trojan War conflict. This is just two sides fighting against each other in some makeup war that they're calling the Trojan War. It doesn't work for me. I know a lot of people, you know, really enjoy Mythos. A lot of people might be playing it on an Epic. And if you're one of those people, then good for you. But I think, in my honest opinion, CA completely missed the mark with Troy, and I kind of wished they'd move on already. And honestly, it's inherently a bit of a slap in the face to people playing who played and still play Three Kingdoms, because if anything deserved more support, it was that game. It was doing a really good job of depicting Three Kingdoms. The story behind it, the history behind it. And I know there's so much to tell there, but they didn't even get to the crux of Three Kingdoms. And instead, we're getting more support for Troy, a game that I don't really think ever deserved more support. So, that's my thoughts about the game, guys. This is my thoughts about the DLC. If you disagree with me, that's absolutely fine. Drop any thoughts or questions in the comment section below. As always, I am super open to changing my mind about this. I slated the Mythos DLC when it first announced. When I reviewed it, I actually quite liked it. So, you know, I'm not someone who will stick to my guns about something and be very stubborn about it. I'm open to changing my mind, to discussing with you guys about what's coming for the game in the comment section below. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like, drop any thoughts or questions in the comment section below, and subscribe for more Total War content, gameplay, and news just like this. Thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.